अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू एंड योर फैमिली मेम्बर्स आर सेफ एंड गुड एट होम। एज़ यू नो डैट द स्कूल्स हैव बीन क्लोज्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ड्यू टू दिस कोरोना वायरस एपिडेमिक, दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव डिसाइडेड दैट वी विल टीच यू फ्रॉम होम। ओके, लास्ट टाइम वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द लाइट ईयर एंड आई ऑल्सो एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द ल्यूमिनस ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड नॉन ल्यूमिनस ऑब्जेक्ट्स। That those objects which have their own light are called luminous objects, for example sun, and those objects which have no light of their own are called non-luminous objects, for example earth. Then we have studied about the day as well as month and a year, and we have studied that when earth completes its one rotation in 24 hours, this is called a day. Actually it is consisted of 23.93 hours, which is rounded off to 24 hours, and it is equal to one day. Then we have studied about a month, then when a moon completes its one whole revolution around the earth, this is called one lunar month, and it is consisted of 27.3 days. And during this the moon passes through different phases. And then we studied about the year, that when a earth completes its one revolution around the sun, this is called 1 year, and it is consisted of 365.25 days, but we can take only 365 days a year. And then after 4 years we add 0.25 days of 4 years, and it becomes 1 day, and that's why the February after four years consisted of 29 days, and this is called leap year. Then we will start from here, and today our topic is eclipses and telescopes. As you know that there are different heavenly bodies in the space around the earth, moon revolves, and around the sun our earth revolves. And similarly there are many planets which revolve around the sun in our solar system, and there are many suns also present in the solar system, in different solar systems. So now, what is eclipse? When a planet or a heavenly body receives light from the sun, and another planet or object or heavenly body comes in that path, then the first object does not receive its light from the sun. This condition is called eclipse. So similarly, it also happened with sun as well as with earth. That's why it is also called lunar eclipse as well as solar eclipse. I will explain it to you with the proper diagram. So here is the diagram. So we are studying from 139 page to 141 page. So there are two type of eclipses. Number one is solar eclipse, and second one is lunar eclipse. So what is solar eclipse? We know that earth revolves around the sun and moon revolves around the earth. While when the earth is revolving around the sun, there comes a condition when the moon comes in between sun and earth. And when the moon comes in between sun and earth, it blocks all the light coming from the sun towards the earth, and that's why the earth becomes dark. Why the earth becomes dark? Because the earth now present in the shadow of the moon, and it is receiving no light. That's why the earth is dark, it is receiving no light. That's why this condition is called solar eclipse. You can see from this diagram, this is sun, this is moon, and this is earth. The rays are coming from the sun, but these are blocked by the moon, and no ray of light is reaching the earth, and this is the shadow, due to which the earth has become darker. The second type of the eclipse is lunar eclipse. In lunar eclipse, now the earth comes in between sun and moon, because we know that moon also receives light from the sun, but when the earth comes in between sun and moon, it actually blocks the light coming from the sun towards the moon, and due to which now the moon is present in the shadow behind the earth, and due to this shadow there is no light on the moon, and the back side of the earth and the moon is totally dark, and this condition is called lunar eclipse. You can see that this is sun, this is earth, and this is moon, and the earth is blocking all the light coming from the sun, and behind the earth this is the shadow and moon is present in this shadow. That's why the moon is dark, it is receiving no light, and this condition is called lunar eclipse. Okay, this is all about eclipses. Now further we will study about telescopes. What are telescopes? Telescopes are just machines invented by human in order to help, in order to study different kind of heavenly bodies. We have studied different objects, micro objects in through microscope in laboratory. Same like this, we studied different heavenly objects through telescope in space. So the first telescope is invented by Galileo in 1609, and with the help of that telescope he studied the properties of Jupiter, especially the moons of Jupiter, and in this telescope lenses were used. And now in modern telescopes, instead of lenses, mirrors are used, and these are very magnified and very high quality images which are taken by these telescopes and then sent to the earth, to the control station. So one of the latest telescope of the modern world, today's world, is Hubble Space Telescope. It is present in the space, sent by the NASA, an American agency related to space. So it revolves around the earth once every 96 minutes, means after 96 minutes it completes its one revolution. Okay, as I told you that the Hubble Space Telescope is the modern and latest telescope, and it completes one revolution around the earth in 96 minutes, and it takes digital images throughout the space of the sun, stars, moon, as well as different planets, and then send it to the earth where it is processed and then examined. There is another type of telescope which is called radio telescope. It actually receives different kind of radio waves sent out by different objects in space to the earth, and here it is then transferred into designated signals, into required signals, and then the scientists do research on these signals and put forth their study. So this is all about our today's lecture, which is from page number 139 to 141, and the questions related to this topic is one long question, which is explain how lunar eclipse and solar eclipse occurs. I have explained it to you. And the other question related to these topics are short question, which is on page number 141, and it is test yourself. This is explain why the stars and planets in the night sky appear to move in circles. Why does the pole star appear not to move? And second one is, what is the difference between an ancient optical telescope and a modern one? Number 3, how are radio telescopes different from optical ones? Number 4, give one advantage that the Hubble Space Telescope has over Earth-based telescopes. Number 5, how have computers helped astronomers? All these are short questions, and you have to write the answer of these questions and one long question which I have told you earlier in your notebooks. Okay, I hope you have enjoyed this lecture. Okay, best of luck. Have a good day. Okay, students, the answer of a long question that explain how lunar eclipse and solar eclipse occurs. So the answer of this question is on page number 139 and on page number 140. Okay, it covered the total topic of eclipses, but you have to arrange it according to the question, and you also have to make the clear diagram on the interleaf page of your notebook. And in addition to this, the answers to these questions, test yourself, are also present on the pay number 140 and pay number 141. When you will thoroughly read these pages, you will get the answers. These questions are very easy and you will find no difficulty to write the answer of these questions. Okay, thank you.